What's going through your injector's mind when they're thinking about the brow lift? So the brow lift is a driver to aesthetic practices. A lot of people talk about the brow lift, kind of like the lip flip, which we went through in a prior video. What exactly is it? What does it mean to each different person? The brow shape is actually very complex, and lifting the brow means something different to everyone. Let's first go through how we get there, the aging brow, really quickly. Then we're gonna go through some vectors, and then we're gonna go through the treatment and what it actually is to lift the brow. So aging of the brow, like with the rest of the face, it's collagen loss, it's a little bit of drooping of the skin, but the bone is the most difficult part, because the easiest way to think of bone is that it melts on the face. So the eye socket actually widens and it rotates the wrong way. Instead of upwards, how females particularly want their brow, it rotates more towards a male position or a downward turn. And that's part of what we're overcoming. And that's why it's also, with the under eye, harder to fill laterally, because the bone gets larger, but it's an important area. So all those factors go into the sagging of the eye, and then we'd be remiss if we didn't talk about the upper lid that can sag, and sometimes just genetically, people have a redundant upper lid, but it also increases with age. So that's part of the aging process. Now on to what do we do about it? Well, to first do anything with the brow, you have to know what's the perfect brow. And there are ethnicities, different people like different styles, and things even come in and out of style. So there are some vectors that we think about, and when your injector's looking at your eye, they're calculating that whether you know it or not. The first one is, in this diagram, you see a line from the nasal ala laterally through the lateral canthus. That usually represents the extent of the lateral brow. Then if you take this diagram with a line that goes from the nasal ala through the mid pupil, that's usually the arch of the brow. So there's different vectors that we're calculating and may not be drawn out on your face, but that's what your injector is thinking about. There's much more to that, but those are two basic lines. From there, we calculate the forehead toxin, dose, and area. And it's all important. And I know we're talking about brow lift, but understand what's lifting your brow? Your frontalis. It usually ends at the temporal crest, but it can extend laterally. Yet another variable your injector's thinking about when calculating what to do with the brow, how to get that perfect arch. Let's go to the treatments. Number one that people think about is neuromodulator or Botox-like products. So when we're injecting this area, think about the easiest, most predictable, safest area to inject, of course, is laterally, those downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi. However, there's really three areas. And in this diagram, you can see the number one, the tarsal area, there's the septal area, and then there's what we call the body, or the main part of the orbicularis oculi, or the orbital part. The orbital part is used to actually create a strong blink. That's when you really push down hard. So you can manipulate these muscles to open the eye more, being careful for dry eye. You can get a brow lift at the mid arch from injecting the muscles that really pull down hard. And then this shows you that muscle is complex. So there's really four different areas where you can manipulate it to get that brow lift. So that's neuromodulators, and that's a real cursory evaluation of them. It's a complex discussion, but it gives you an idea what goes through the injector's mind. And if you didn't get that perfect brow lift, sticking with that injector to get your pattern that's specific to you. Everyone's muscle is going to be a little bit different. Some are stronger, some are weaker, some will get the lift when you inject that area, others just won't get a result. So it's playing and manipulating that area. Second, fillers. Okay, what are we filling? Two things, and I'm gonna include fillers and collagen stimulators along the same, because this is what I use in that area, a lot more collagen stimulators than fillers, but it's filling the brow and the temple. Very few people think of the temple, but if you think a hollow temple, the arch of the brow is what we lose, and you get that kind of a comma looking brow. And it can be arched because people try and lift their eyes, and so they get a very unusual arch of the brow and the tail drops off. So you see how complex it is, but fillers can be used to lift the brow. One thing I'm going to include in the brow, of course, is hair growth. And I know everyone's microblading, tattooing, but people like hair on the brow. So PRF, or platelet-rich fibrin, can be used in this area, plus or minus a cell or similar products, to help stimulate the growth. And we'll include that here as part of the treatment options for that perfect brow. The next treatment to consider, radio frequency or devices, and certainly using heating to build and stimulate collagen can provide an immediate lift. People see it right away. And that might go away after a couple of weeks, but it can stay high. But what I'm looking for is the long-term collagen growth in the forehead region so that lines don't develop. Why? The more toxin we put up here, neuromodulator, the more you drop and you lose that perfect brow. The last one, and all important, everyone should get with a brow lift, is PDO threads. And I love smooth threads. If you follow my videos, you know, everyone that I want to lift the brow in, I want to put smooth threads above the brow to build collagen, give a little bit of volume. You can use twist as well. They work good, especially if you want a little more volume than smooth, but it builds collagen so that you don't have to use the neuromodulator in that danger zone at the temporal crest. And I'll go through in other videos, you can look back and where I draw the area out to really know how to mark that frontalis muscle so you don't get droop. So that's the brow. Understand how much goes into it. To get a perfect brow shape, it's style, it's filler, neuromodulator, devices, PDO threads, and that still might leave some people wanting a surgical result depending on the stage of the skin laxity and bone changes. Thanks for joining me here. Join us over on Instagram for continued helpful tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.